Welcome to today's episode of the Relationship the Right Way in Jenny Moments. My name is Jennifer Ugo, and of course, I'm glad to see you again today. How has your week been? Of course, I hope you're ready for this weekend because I am so ready. As you can see, I'm very, very fine, heart ready to cruise into the weekend. Yeah, this is the avenue where I talk about every aspect of human relationship. Of course, you know, the first Friday of the month. Yes, wow, I really feel like it's February 14th already. Yeah, this is the month of love, and of course, I know you have a great plan for this month. How many of my videos have you seen this year? Go by you. You've not seen up to 4 videos. That means you've missed the whole of January videos. So just click on that subscribe button right now so that you don't have to miss the remaining 52 or thereabouts Fridays. I'm going to be here talking to you. Yes, how am I making this hot? Last week I was talking about tough love. Yes, did you see that video? Everybody's talking about. So if you've not seen it, you better watch right now and go and see, because it's a bomb. Today, I want to talk about something that everybody keeps asking me about. Okay, you know, everybody has been asking me, Jennifer. Okay, like, I've run into some people, a girl tell me, Jennifer, my guy left me because I refused to be intimate with him. And the guy would be like, I want to leave her, she refused to be intimate with me. And then the question of today is, what then is intimacy? Yeah, in relationship, okay? Intimacy can mean a lot of things. But I will start by explaining what the English dictionary says intimacy is. Simply, English dictionary defines intimacy as that feeling or atmosphere of closeness or openness with someone else, not necessarily involving sexuality. So that's the last line, not necessarily involving sexuality. So that means that you can actually be in a relationship with someone without involving sex. Yeah, and you are intimate. And you can also be in a relationship with someone having sex every day, and yet you are not intimate. So the question then is, what is intimacy for you? So today I'm looking at intimacy and how it has is going to make or mark your relationships. Yes, I'll start by number one. If you are a married person, okay, of course you know that intimacy is very important in a relationship. Sadly, some of us are even married and yet we live like housemates with our partners. And then you'll be asking, what happened to all the love we had? You allowed it to die. Why? Because of stresses of work, stresses of raising kids and the rest of it, and then you forget that your intimacy is very important in the relationship and you have to work very to keep the fire going. So if you are a married woman or married man listening to this my video or watching this my video, one assignment today is check back what is taking away the intimacy you have with your husband. I mean, all the openness, the things you share, what happened at work today, how was your day, who was the toast that toasted you today, and was that woman you ran into that, you know, tickled your fancy, and rest of all these things. And of course, to crown it all, good sex is very important for married people. Trust me, no matter how holy you pretend to be, or how you think, you don't need it. It is the spark that keeps your relationship going as a married person. So, get it on, okay? Bring back that intimacy to that your marriage so that you will not be dreaming of ever cheating on your partner, because by the time you're so intimate with your partner, all you see is that person and you will not have time for another person, okay? That's about that for this married people and for us, the single people. Yes, now, that's a serious case, because as a single person, okay, if you have made up your mind that, okay, I'm not going to have intimacy in the area of sex in my relationship, please define it from the beginning. And when you define, stick to it, okay? And I'm telling you, girl, if a guy says he's leaving you because you have refused to give him sex, my dear, that guy is not for for you. He's not. So the only thing you're going to do is leave his ass where you met him. All right? That's the right thing to do. Exactly. Leave him where you met him. So if you are the guy who says you're leaving your girl because she has refused to be intimate with you, now the question I have for you is, what exactly do you mean by intimacy? Like, you want her to be having sex with you when you're married to her? Some ladies just don't want to do that, okay? Just want to live their life, build a good relationship, and have good marriage in the future. So if you miss that kind of woman who is saying, sorry, I don't want sexual intimacy in this relationship, don't walk away. If you love her, and if you know she has the qualities you want, stick around and try to make the relationship work. It's not all about sexual intimacy. Now, you can go about intimacy in another different way, okay? Spend more time together, be open, talk about your past, talk about your present, talk about your fancy, talk about everything you like. Of course, that will help you stay intimate, open and close with each other. That is the aspect of intimacy I, Jennifer, is recommending for the single people. Because a lot of girls, okay, just keep lamenting, he used me and he dumped me. Why won't he use you and dump you when you're not irresistible? Oh, okay, that's another topic for another day. Irresistible. I'm going to talk about that because it's a different thing, attracting someone and starting a relationship with that person. But it's another entirely different thing, becoming irresistible by that person. So you see, it's a different thing entirely, but that's being a topic for another day. I know you will not miss it because I'm going to talk about it. So that's about intimacy. Now, we live in a world where a lot of people are angry and sad and depressed. They make mistakes in their relationship and they are happy, but they're not happy. So what do? They just try their best to bring you down to their level of anger and sadness. And you do what you allow it. They tell you, I saw your guy the other day at that place with one girl. And so what? Is it a man who's supposed to see her guy with? That brings me to the person I'm talking about. You can be a friend to someone. That does not mean you guys are sleeping with each other. So by the time they come telling you, I saw your husband with one girl in one place, ask them, what did you see them doing? Of course, if they say they saw each other sleeping with each other, then don't just rush and start accusing your husband. Take your time to find out yourself. By the time you do that yourself, then you can be able to say, okay, I've caught you red-handed, and this is my decision. Perhaps he has a reason for it. The final reason why he did that, and then make sure you keep your relationship, because a lot of people are not happy. That is why in Nigeria it seems very difficult for celebrity marriages to work, because everybody is poking into the relationship. Everybody wants to know what is happening. All the bloggers are busy saying rubbish. Everybody is just seeing everything. Today in this vlog, my dears, if you've not learned anything, learn to trust your partner. Learn to know that your partner who is not cheating on you could never be intimate sexually with another person. Okay? So when they come telling you, girlfriend, I met your guy the other day with one girl, okay, say thank you, and then work on towards finding out yourself. Okay, I'm not going to tell you to just call it up and say the guy is a good guy, he's a cheat. No, you know, some guys do cheat. We know that there are some guys who really do cheat. Okay, but what I'm talking about is, if you get those kind of tip-offs, some of them are not really good. They're just there to bring you back to their sadness or down to their level of unhappiness, and then all of you will become the same thing. So you can't have the woman to do shakara that's okay, and I have a guy and all that for them. So they are just working hard to make sure that you have a heartbreak, your relationship is not breaking, you are sad like them. My dear, what you are going to do today, know it, and I say it again, is that intimacy, okay, is in two ways. If you are in a relationship and you have made up your mind to stay away from sexual intimacy, please keep it. All right, if you have made up your mind to stay away from everything that has to be intimate, okay, openness and all that, define it too. Okay, in a relationship that's not defined, always have issues. But when you define it, this guy knows that, oh no, this is no good area. This guy knows that this is no good area. Everybody comes with a plate, you know. Hence, so that's what I'm going to be stopping for today. to educate the world, and I want you to be part of it. Because you know what? Together we can change the world. So that's where I'm going to stop for today. I am your beautiful Jennifer Ogbo, and I love you so much. Stay tuned, and stay tuned. I mean, stay tuned in your relationship in the right ways. Until I come your way next week. Don't forget, it's a week to Valentine's, first Friday of February. Of course, I'll be here with Valentine's edition of this vlog. You can't wait to miss it. So till then, bye. I love you.
Relationship the Right Way program, impacting your life as never before.